Namashiva students, hope you have read the poem The Secret Cavern written by Margaret Widama. Now let me explain the poem. The child in this poem is talking about a secret hiding place. Now, what is a cavern? Cavern is a large cave or a chamber in a cave. Here, the child's cave can be found under the woodwork. Maybe the child lives near a lakeside or a beachside. So this place is a way, way back under the woodwork. If you want to go inside, then you need to crawl and you will find a big black cave. None of all the other children know. This line, the poetess repeat in all the four stanzas to emphasize that it is the child's secret from the whole world. The child is emphasizing so because it is a very important place where the child relieves his fantasy, keeping it away from the world, and being secretive creates an aura of adventure. In that place, the child hides his or her treasures. Treasures like shells, colored glass, queer-shaped rocks, clamshells. The child had dug it out and decorated it too with yellow pebbles. The cave has enough room for chests, weapons, and one chair. Now, why only one chair is mentioned here? It is mentioned so because the child wanted this as his or her very own secret place. Then the child will keep a flag with skulls and bones drawn on it, a lamp which will give an eerie effect to the cave. Just like the movie Pirates of Caribbean, isn't it so? Then the child implores more into the future. The child says that when he or she will grow up, he or she will start living there all alone, which is a mere figment of the child's imagination. The child more imagines to dig and move all day in a boat. Then at night, the child will work with his or her pirate ship and fill up the secret cavern with prisoners from enemy side. But none of all the other children know. No one will come to know. It's a secret. So children, what do you think about this? Do you have a hiding place? Just think of all the pictures and feelings the poem has aroused in us. We have had so many good ideas about the poem, about secret place and being alone, that I think we all would enjoy, like by doing painting pictures, reading books, etc., or maybe a secret hiding place. This poem gives you a view how to spend your free time with creativeness. Be creative, students. Read this poem again and again and think, introspect yourself. This is an imaginative poem prompting you to delve into your desires and plans. Think, be creative. Now students, let us mark the spellings with pencil in your book. Okay, number one is underneath, UNDERNEATH. Number two, splendid, SPLENDID. Number three, crawl, CRAWL. Number four, paddling, PADDLING. Number five, treasures, TREASURES. Number six, clamshells, CLAMSHELLS. Number seven, pirate, PIRATE. Number eight, captive, CAPTIVE. Now four means enemy. It is written over here. See? Okay? So students, We have finished reading and explaining also. Wait for the next class. Till then, students, Namah Shivaya.